वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई विल इंट्रोड्यूस माई सेल्फ सरप्रीत कौर. आई एम वर्किंग एज एन असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन पंजाब यूनिवर्सिटी. सो माई एरिया ऑफ इंटरेस्ट इज इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग, पावर सिस्टम, फाइनाइट एलिमेंट मैथड्स, एनर्जी मैनेजमेंट, ऑडिटिंग एंड सो ऑन. सो टूडे वी विल डिस्कस एनर्जी एफिशियंट टेक्नोलॉजीज. सो बिफोर वी स्टार्ट लेट मी clarify, because today each and every area of research is concerned on the efficiency, conservation, the latest technologies, the latest techniques that we are studying. So energy efficiency, first of all we will discuss the concept of energy efficiency. What do you mean by energy efficiency? Energy efficiency is the more effective, or you can say the minimum waste. Minimum waste means minimum losses. More effective and with the minimum losses, utilization of primary energy sources like solar, wind and other that are already available naturally, like our fossil fuels, means all the primary energy sources which are available naturally. So utilization of these primary sources to provide a desired energy service. Any type of service, you can say the manufacturing of a product, or you can say at the transportation, wherever you require the energy service, and then the cooking, lighting and other services where you require the energy. So it is a more effective, more efficiently utilization of the primary energy sources to provide a desired energy service for the manufacture of a product, for the transportation or cooking or lighting. So therefore, to maximizing the benefits of energy use while minimizing its cost. Because when we talk about the term efficiency means we have to use our energy resources very efficiently and with the minimum usage of cost and its impact on the environment. Okay, because when we are studying these effects, we have to see the environmental effects of it. So minimizing the cost plus its impact on the environment. So all these areas to be considered before we are going to evaluate any efficiency of the energy, etc. So there are two concepts basically. One is your energy efficiency and the second one is energy conservation. Both terms, they are very related to each other, energy efficiency and energy conservation. Both terms, energy efficiency and conservation, they mean same, because the both meaning is to use the less energy. Either you are using the energy efficiently or you are using the for conservation. So therefore, energy conservation and energy efficiency, both means using less energy. But there is a difference between the energy efficiency and energy conservation. The difference is energy conservation means not using energy at all. You have to purely, properly, you have to conserve it. You have to preserve it for your long-term use. Such as turning off the lights when leaving a room. You have to switch it off, or utilizing the daylighting through windows rather than turning on the lights. So energy conservation means you have to properly conserve it, preserve it. But in case of energy efficiency is using the less energy to perform the same function. Means you have to efficiently use the energy. The function should be same, but you have to properly use it. Such as, jaise hum aajkal CFLs, we are using it. CFL bulbs that will use less energy to illuminate a room. Means we are using the energy, but we are using in it more effective and efficient way. So that we should save our energy for our long-term usage. So therefore, energy efficiency and energy conservation, both are related terms. Both means they are using less energy. But in energy conservation, we are totally preserving it. We are not at all using it for our long-term future. But in energy efficiency means using energy to perform the same function, but use it with more efficiently, more effective ways. Now, why do efficiently we use energy? Why energy efficiency? What is the purpose behind it? Why we are using it? What is the basic idea of using the energy more efficiently? Because if we use our energy inefficiently means we directly relate it to the higher cost of our devices, equipments, energy resources, etc. So therefore, it impart higher cost to the companies and industries which are using it, to the end user, like we are the end user, like the customers who are using these energy resources, and also to the environment. Because already I have already told you, the energy means the resources, it should minimize the cost, and it we have to also consider its impact on the environment. So inefficient use of energy that will result in higher cost to the companies, to the industries, to the end user, to the environment, etc. So we have to be very careful while using the energy. We have to be very careful because we have to preserve it. Energy usage environmentally determinant. Environment, climatic changes, there are so many factors that affect it, but we have to use the efficiently we have to use the energy so that its environmental impact should be minimum. Like locally kya kuch impact ho sakta hai, soil degradation, poor air quality, that can affect. Globally any climatic changes there. So that is why, because we are, the question is why energy efficiency? So we have to consider its environmental effects, whether it is locally or whether it is globally. And another important factor is conventional energy sources are very finite. There are limited sources of conventional energy sources like coal, like petroleum. We have now left with the very limited stock of it. So we have to conserve these resources, and the resources can be conserved only if we use these resources very efficiently. Because there are many technologies, there are many techniques by which we can use these energy more efficiently. I will discuss these technologies later on, but first of all is the why is this energy efficiency. Then more efficient use of energy means greater availability of resources. More efficient, efficiency jitni zyada hamara efficiently hum energy ko use karenge, utna hi hamari resources ki availability badhegi. Because I have already discussed ki there are limited sources, at least conventional sources, they are very limited. Even there is an idea ki how much coal reserves are, coal reserves will last for up to how many years, another 20 years, 30 years or 40 years. Similarly, the case with the petroleum. There are so many resources which we have to conserve. So these resources can be conserved only if we are using the energy more efficiently. And the technologies that we are going to discuss here is how we can use the energy efficiently. There are different technologies, right? So the change of technology, this is the main key. We all are discussing these days the technology. Technology is with the every field, whether it is electrical, mechanical, computer, IT, civil, etc. Technology is in now the each and every area of the science or engineering. So change of technology is the main key behind this. If we are talking about energy efficiency, we have to change the technology. We have to upgrade our technology. So how can we upgrade? By installation of energy efficient infrastructure. When we are talking about infrastructure, like I have already said, energy efficiency technology, it is related to the all fields of sciences and engineering. So installation of energy efficiency infrastructure, the equipment, all the appliances, this is essential for meeting the energy demand. जितनी डिमांड है इन ऑर्डर टू मीट दैट डिमांड, इन ऑर्डर टू मैनेज द सिक्योरिटी ऑफ द एनर्जी एंड इन ऑर्डर टू मीट द क्लाइमेटिक गोल्स. सो ओनली थिंग इज यू हैव टू अपग्रेड, यू हैव टू चेंज, यू हैव टू एनालाइज योर टेक्नोलॉजी, हाउ यू कैन यूज मोर एफिशिएंट वे ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजीज, बिकॉज नाउ टेक्नोलॉजी अप्लाई टू ऑल द फील्ड्स. So this is essential in order to meet your demands, security, that is very important issue, and your climatic goals. Any change in climatic season, so that is one. Then technological transitions, both deployment and development, they are important in the power generation, in buildings. Like power generation means that is related with electrical, buildings means that is related with the civil, commercial buildings means especially they discuss about these because nowadays there are so many like you can say the building codes are available, there are specific energy conservation building standards are available. So then equipment and appliances, they are also related with the electrical and industries, so they all have to go for a transition in their technology. They have to see the generation point, like the supply side and also the demand side. You can say there are two sides. One is the supply side that I will discuss in my later on the PPTs. Demand side and the supply side. There are two sides. One is power generation, then you have transmission, and then finally the distribution. That means we are the on the demand side, and power generation, power plants, they are also on the generation side. That is the supply side. So the technological transition should be from the supply side to the demand side. Now obviously when we are talking so many things, energy efficiency, the transitions, the technology, obviously the India has to frame some regulatory framework. There have to be some policies, there have to be some policy framework, some conservation act, some standards, some labels should be there. So Energy Conservation Act. So with the background of high energy saving potential and its benefits, bridging the gap between the demand and the supply and reducing the environmental issues, so Government of India, they have framed some regulations, some act, some standards for this. So the Government of India has enacted the Conservation Act 2001. Which was very, very important. I think most of us should aware of this Energy Conservation Act 2001. Because according to this act, they created Bureau of Energy Efficiency, that is BEE. Appliances, standards and its labeling. There should be some standard fixed. There should be the labels on these there should be some labels on all the appliances and the devices we are using. Energy consumption norms, energy use reporting requirement for energy intensive industrial units, energy conservation building codes, that is certified energy managers and auditors. So according to Conservation Act, first they created Bureau of Energy Efficiency. Bureau of Energy Efficiency, I think most of us should aware of it, ki when we are going to buy any appliance, anything, we usually take care of these, how much star rating is the appliance, whether it is 2-star, 3-star, 4-star. It depends upon the performance of that particular appliance, like any refrigerator or AC. We first of all just see ki whether it is 2-star, 3-star, 4-star. We always look, who decide these star ratings? The Bureau of Energy Efficiency. They decide the star rating of your appliances, your devices. They set the standards. There should be some particular standards. There should be some particular labels. Then if we go for energy auditing, now it is compulsory for all the industries, for all the factories to go for the energy auditing, to prepare energy audit reports. Then you have to analyze that report. Then you implement the report, because the suggestions and the recommendations that is given in the energy report, you have to implement that. And these all things, they are covered by the energy managers and auditors. This is a certified course by the BEE. You can also go for that course, energy, how to do the energy auditors, how to do the energy auditing. It is a certified courses. Then the main important point is energy conservation building codes, ECBC. Energy conservation building codes, it is also a very important topic these days. Energy conservation building codes. Now, what information that helps the customers to take the decisions? Obviously, it is BEE. BEE will decide what is the star rating. That will help the customer how efficiently this device is which I am going to purchase, whether it is 2-star, whether it is 3-star or 4-star. So BEE will decide the star rating of the equipment. So these types of labels you must have seen on your devices, on your appliances, refrigerators, AC, so many things. So usually we just see whether it is 2-star, 3-star, 4-star, depending upon how much energy it is consuming, what is the input, what is the output, all these efficiency, or how much efficiency, kitni hamari saving ho rahi hai, all these things. Similarly, when we are talking about the power saving guide for your appliances, similarly there are some for the star rating for buildings also. Two important areas they covered. First is your appliances, all the electrical appliances, then the star ratings for your buildings. What is the type of building, category, uska area kitna hai, what are the appliances they are using, how they are utilizing the daylights, how they are utilizing the solar energy, how they are utilizing so many things, so many in the infrastructure, the cooling system, the heating system, all these things they decide by the auditors and the Bureau of Energy Efficiency. They decide the how much stars the buildings have attained. Star ratings for the buildings as well as for the appliances. I think you all must know ki what are the appliances, uspe to star rating hoti hai, but there are star ratings for buildings also. So BEE is moving forward with the national labeling and standards for the equipments. All the equipments, unke kuch standards fix hai, labels they have labelized. Because if you see this graph, number of units and the efficiency. Original जो थी हमारे पास distribution, the efficiency standards, ठीक है, there is a magnetic pull, there is a the market pull, जिसमें हमारे पास काफी कुछ changes आई हैं, हमारे पास technology की changes आई है, जिसने हमारी efficiency को improve किया, right? So energy efficiency, it is a rising concern. Before I start with the different technologies, energy efficient technologies that we are using in our being a person related to the engineering or the sciences, so we should know what are the different technologies. So I'm going to switch over to that technologies, but first of all, the energy efficiency, why we require, because energy efficiency, it is related with the generation. Like I have seen, I have shown these generation, like it's a type of thermal plant, any power plant that is a source of generation, then transmission, then distribution, because all these three they are related with each other, generation, transmission and distribution. So energy efficiency, it is a rising concern. Different factors that depends on the energy efficiency: deregulation, generation capacity and the grids, demand is booming, natural resources, oil and gas, they are declining, so policy and environment. So all these factors, they are required, they depend. You can say these factors dependent upon the energy efficiency, or you can say energy efficiency is dependent upon these factors, because all these factors, they are related with the power generation, transmission and the distribution. So deregulation of both production and supply of gas and electricity. With transmission, they implies to build new business models significantly. Huge investment is needed, involving an increase in the price of both gas and electricity. So generation capacity or grids ka gaya. Demand is booming because the lack of electricity generation capacity, peak prices are becoming very high. Jitne bhi hamari maximum demand hogi. Now, you know, the maximum demand is the demand. Either we have to reach that demand during a 30 minutes of period during the whole month, but that demand is calculated in your tariff. So we have to be very careful before reaching that goal. Don't go for the maximum demand. Try to stabilize your demand. You have to stabilize during the demand period when you are going to attain a peak value. Try to cut off or shed off the loads that is not required, so that your demand, like the load curve, you know that the load curve, that should be stable. So natural resources, already explained ki the conventional resources, they are finite. We know that they are very limited sources now. Natural resources, oil, gas, and even we know that the oil and coal, they will last only for few more years. So we have to conserve these. Policies, jaise abhi maine bataya aapko, for India, there are some regulatory frameworks, kuch policies define ho gayi hain, kuch act ban rahe hain, jinke accordingly hi wo sare hamare aage technologies ke kaam chalte hain, right? So, अब हमने देखना है what are the different aspects that we need to consider for going for the more efficient energy technologies. There are two sides, either the supply side or the demand side. Supply side is means on the generation side, and demand side means like we are on the demand sides. Any industry, any factory, any organization, anything that is on the demand, even our homes, houses, they are also, they are all things, they are on the demand side. So on the supply side, deploy efficient substation automation. Automation ke aajkal bahut concept chal raha hai. What is automation? We are going for automation completely. Automatic power factor controller, automatic maximum demand controller, automatic lighting controls, all things are going to be automatic. Upgrade to smart metering solution. Smart meters, digital, और भी smart meters आ रहे हैं जिससे हमारा even we can check it out कि कोई maximum demand, कोई peak आर तो नहीं touch हो रहा, we can also see for that. Measure and improve delivered power quality. Power quality कैसी हम deliver कर रहे हैं? Then implement distributed generation in frequently congested area. So all these factors that should be considered for the supply side. In continuation with this, introduce new tariff structures and smart revenue metering. New structures unko introduce karna with the smart metering solutions. Then provide customers with accurate and relevant consumption data. Because consumers, the customers, they are very much aware nowadays. They want to see each and every part of their usage. How much energy they are using, how much data, how many number of units, what is a peak demand, what is our load demand, total load kitna specified hai, each and everything. So we should provide customers with accurate and relevant consumption data. Then high speed telecom infrastructures, and then modern energy information system, so that easily, that immediately the information is transferred to the customers as well as to the demand side and the supply side. Similarly, on the demand side, what factors to be considered? They are, educate people on the efficient use of energy. First thing is this, act on business related procedures, replace, renovate aging loads, like the things which are going aging, like you know that concept of aging, aging of motors, transformers, other lights, yes, lighting, motors, high voltage AC, etc. Implement intelligent load control, variable speed drives, regulation system, controllers, demand controllers, etc. In continuation with this, on the demand side, measure and improve on-site power quality. Implement the backup generation. Exploit co-generation means, co-generation when there is a combination of two, like steam plus hydro. So we should also go for that. Use the right tariff according to specific load profile and resell excess power. That is to the resell the excess power to the grids. So this was a very much basic, what is energy efficiency? What is, I have already explained the difference between the energy efficiency and energy conservation. How these two terms are related, energy conservation and energy efficiency. What are the regulatory frameworks that is to be done for India? The creation of the Bureau of Energy Efficiency, Energy Conservation Act 2001, I have discussed. So all these terms, they are related with the energy efficient technologies. These terms are general, ki why we go for energy efficient technologies, but being a man of engineering sciences, or because our field is basically the sciences, so we should know about the technology. So first technology, that is energy efficient motors. I think maybe some other person maybe have already told you what are the energy efficient motors. Similarly, energy efficient transformers. Okay, you should, you are from electrical engineering? Okay, then that's okay. Motors,
mechanical.
But I think motors, transformer, ye to bahut basic tha jo sabko pata hi hota hai. Then soft starters, starter that we are using with the induction motor. Energy efficient lighting controls, even these controls now we are going implement in our houses also. Like we are replacing our tube lights or anything else with the CFLs or LEDs now. Energy efficient lamps, maximum demand controller. जैसे मैंने अभी बताया था, what is the maximum demand? कि if you are using your energy.
We have a question from BIT University.
Yes, sir.
Could you please elaborate soft starters, as in energy efficient technology?
That will come in after 2-3 slides. I will explain each and every energy efficient motors, transformers, soft starters, each and everything will be discussed in detail now. Just I am going to give the overview,
okay,
but the trends we are going to discuss, the efficient technologies. Maximum demand controller.
Okay,
and
thank
automatic
you.
Power factor controller. Is that okay? So these all energy efficient technologies.
Thank you, ma'am. Please continue.
Okay. So all these recent trends in energy efficient technologies we will discuss one by one. Energy efficient motors, starter, transformers, soft starters, lightning controls, efficient lamps, maximum demand controller, and then the power factor controller. So first of all, we will discuss what is energy efficient motor. So motors is मोटर्स तो सबको पता ही है. सो वी विल डिस्कस व्हाट इज एनर्जी एफिशिएंट मोटर. एफिशिएंसी मींस आउटपुट ओवर इनपुट. व्हाट इज आउटपुट? इनपुट प्लस लॉसेस, सॉरी इनपुट माइनस लॉसेस. सो दैट मींस वी हैव टू कंट्रोल आवर लॉसेस. इफ वी कंट्रोल आवर लॉसेस द एफिशिएंसी विल बी इंप्रूव्ड. दीज लॉसेस, दीज आर द वॉट लॉसेस, दैट इज द minimizing the watts loss in motors. A reduction in watts losses, it can be achieved in various ways. I will discuss these ways, which area of the motor that we can save our energy. How can we reduce the losses? All of these changes to reduce the motor losses, they are possible with the existing motor design. You need not to design a new motor and manufacturing technology. It would require additional materials, like we use some core material, some stator, conductor materials, just a change of material with the only existing design of higher quality materials and improved manufacturing processes results in the increased, that will no doubt result in some in cost increase, but later on the efficiency itni achhi ho jati hai ki hamare jo output aayegi that will compensate the initial cost. Right. So what are the different areas of the motors where we can improve our efficiency? First is iron, stator I square R, rotor I square R. Now when related with the iron, low loss core steel reduces the eddy current losses. Right? Use of more copper and large conductors, that will increase the area. If the area increases, resistance will decrease, that will decrease the winding and resistance of the winding, and that will reduce the losses. Similarly for the rotor, use of large rotor conductor bars, it increases the size of the cross section, that lowers the conductor resistance and reduces the losses due to the current flow. Okay, in continuation with this, there are two more areas, that are friction and winding losses, and the another is stray load losses. All these losses, they are, you have already studied in the motors. Now what are the factors that need to be considered for the friction and winding losses. Use of low loss fan design that reduces the losses due to the air movement. Use of optimized design and strict quality control producers, they minimize the stray load losses. So all these areas, iron, stator, rotor, friction and winding losses, and then the stray load losses. All these areas, if we go for some, like you can say that some changes in its designing, some manufacturing, no need to change the overall design. Just introduce some new concepts like new core material, like some new conductor material. Like they have said, just increase the area of the stator that will reduce the resistance, then decrease the losses. Similarly, just use of low loss fan design that will reduce the friction and winding losses, etc. So this is a type of energy efficient motor. They have discussed all these. I will let you explain. I think you found both small hai. First is starting from the very left corner. Copper wires, they are of large diameter for the stator. Ultimately, वही है कि हमने stator का size बड़ा किया, rotor के conductors को बड़ा कर देंगे. Due to increase of size, the area will increase, the resistance will decrease, and losses will decrease because of the increase in the current, right? In the center, it is the thin steel laminations that is required for the iron material. Then efficient cooling from that right hand corner, cooling of the with the low loss fan design. Then steel cores, then conductors, stator conductors, rotor conductors. So all these that jo humne pichli wali slides mein ki na, all these they are discussed as a part of the motor. How can we efficiently improve the efficiency of our motor? Now this was all about the energy efficient motors. Next is your energy efficient transformers. Transformer, we know, just transfer of energy from one winding to another by keeping the supply constant, frequency constant, sorry. So what is energy efficient transformers? The conventional transformer is made up of a silicon alloyed iron grain oriented core. The iron loss of any transformer, it depends upon which type of core used in the transformer. The latest technology is to use the amorphous type core, which is also known as the metallic glass. There is a lot of research is going on in this area. You have earlier the silicon steel, grain oriented, soft, sabse pehle to soft iron hota tha, then silicon steel with much better quality, they improve the efficiency, but nowadays amorphous. No doubt initial cost is high, but the transformer efficiency is so much improved that will compensate later on. So amorphous core material or metallic glass for the alloy. The expected reduction in energy loss over the conventional transformer is roughly around 70%, which is quite significant. So this much is a reduction of the losses. Amorphous core with specific physical and magnetic properties, they have increased efficiency even at low loads. 98.5% bhi aa sakti hai agar hamara 35% bhi load hai transformer pe, with the use of amorphous core material. Though these transformers, they are little costlier than the conventional iron core transformer, but the overall benefit towards energy savings will compensate for the higher initial investment. So there are other things also that we can experiment with the transformer to make it more energy efficient transformer. These things are energy efficient transformers. They should be star rated, and who will decide the star rating? BEE, and they will check out the in its performance, its output, its input, the efficiency, the losses at the different loadings of the transformer. Additional earth bushing. Yes.
Ma'am, what makes amorphous transformers higher efficient? What is the quality of amorphous core that is increasing the efficiency of a transformer?
Actually, there are different types of amorphous materials like metallic glass. I think it is a 2601 SA. There are different standards that are available. So we have to look for its physical as well as its other properties, like how much is its strength, the resistivity, all these physical properties they have to be considered before going for a metallic glass core material. So we have to look for its physical and yes.
So is it because of the mechanical constraints or electrical property of amorphous core?
Both physical as well as the other properties, not only the electrical. Both constraints they are to be considered, because when we are going for amorphous core, we have to study the flux density, the magnetic flux, the current density, all the areas that need to be considered.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
So it guaranteed the maximum temperature rise. Guaranteed
Hello, ma'am. I am from JCRC Electrical Engine, Jaipur, and I want to ask you one question on synchronous motor EMF equation. When synchronous motor area is more than the turns will be less. So how will we manage the losses on EMF synchronous?
On the EMF equation?
EMF equation synchronous 4.44 F phi TPH volt.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am. So when we increase the area, the turns on synchronous motor will be less. Area conductor ka area apan jyada karenge to turn kam ho jayenge.
Nahi, you can change the type of the turns. There are different types of winding turns. You can change.
Yes, ma'am. We can change in turns. Then what is the effect on losses on EMF?
On the EMF?
Yes.
Losses. If we change the number of turns, that will affect the, I think, flux will be affected. If we change the turn, the flux will be affected. Right? If we change the flux, the frequency is a constant.
Yes.
So that will affect the EMF.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
So far we have discussed the energy efficient motors, energy efficient transformers. I am keeping in mind, because you all know the what is motor, what is transformer, but how efficiently we can use it. Now next is soft starters. Now what are these soft starters? When we start an AC induction motor, it develops more torque in the starting than that is required at the full speed. So that means the rapid acceleration, it has a considerable impact on the electricity supply that charges with the high inrush current. Agar starting mein hi itna zyada inrush current aa jayega, that means motor will accelerate. Either it will accelerate or then during the deceleration also. So soft starters, they provide a reliable and economical solution to these problems by delivering a controlled release of power to the motor. It will deliver a controlled power to the motor so that uski acceleration or deceleration mein koi zyada us time effect na pade motor. Therefore, providing the smooth and the stepless acceleration and deceleration. So this is a soft starter. Now, इससे क्या होगा, द मोटर लाइफ विल बी एक्सटेंडेड एज डैमेज टू द वाइंडिंग्स एंड द बेयरिंग्स इज रिड्यूस्ड. सो दिस इज अ मोटर स्टार्टर. सो ये वाले इज द लुक ऑफ द सॉफ्ट स्टार्टर्स दैट वी कैन सी. अगर हम कहीं भी जाएं किसी फैक्ट्री वगैरह में, यू कैन आस्क फॉर द सॉफ्ट स्टार्टर्स. व्हाट आर द एडवांटेजेस ऑफ सॉफ्ट स्टार्टर? अ सॉफ्ट स्टार्टर, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, इट इज अ डिवाइस यूज्ड विद द एसी इलेक्ट्रिक मोटर्स टू टेंपरेरली रिड्यूस द लोड एंड टॉर्क इन द पावर ट्रेन and electric current surge of the motor during the startup. Different, it reduces the mechanical stress, it improves the power factor, it will lower the maximum demand, and it will also impact on the less mechanical maintenance. So we required soft starter for the induction motor. क्योंकि अगर ताकि starting में जो हमारा एकदम से उसका torque develop होता है, that should be smooth and stepless. ताकि उसका हमारी मोटर पे कुछ इफेक्ट हो. देन Next,
excuse me, ma'am.
Efficient, yes.
Ma'am, I have a question on soft starters. How it is working actually? Is there some power electronic device in it or what inside yes, that box?
Yes, yes. It is based on the power electronics. There are two, three types of. You can look for that soft starters. Like programmable bhi hote hain, microprocessor based bhi hote hain soft starters. Some electronic device. It is a type of electronic device. That will
how it is working actually.
So it will give a. There are two, three types of soft starters. Whether it is depending on the microprocessor based program. Otherwise, if we use some electronic device, it gives a feedback. So the comparator ke saath deal karte, then it will be output signal.
So ma'am, thank you.
Yeah, you have to control it not. So next is efficient technology, energy efficient light controls.
Hello.
Is there some?
There is a question.
Yes.
How the soft starters will into the power factor?
Pardon?
How soft starters
will
into the power factor?
How it will?
Power factor improvement by using soft starters.
It will improve the power factor.
How it will improve the power factor?
Because if our power is controlled, soft starter means. Soft starter purpose is to control the power, to control the release of the power. So power factor is, it is a ratio of real or apparent power. If your power is controlled, that means that power factor will also be improved. Is that okay? The next is energy efficient lighting controls. So different lighting controls, different technologies that is related with the lighting, that is related with the control of, because the main portion where we can save our energy is the lighting, whether the lighting of our houses, industries, factories, other. So there are two, three devices that can be used for the lighting. One is the occupancy sensor, one is the time-based control, one is the use of the daylighting control. There are different types of controllers. First is your occupancy sensors. What is occupancy? Occupancy means whether the area is occupied or whether it is not occupied. So there should be some sensors that will detect whether the area is occupied. If the area is occupied, lights will be switched on. If the area is unoccupied, automatically light will be switched off. So occupancy sensor, occupancy linked control can be achieved using infrared, acoustic, ultrasonic or microwave sensors. These are different types of sensors. Infrared, like if there is some person, the movement of the person, that will generate the heat. So the infrared based sensors that will work. Acoustic means some sound. Ultrasonic or microwave sensors to detect the occupancy of a person, which detect either the movement or the noise in the room spaces. These sensors, they switch the lights on and off depending upon the occupancy, because its name is clear, occupancy sensors. They are designed to prevent a situation where the lighting is left on in an unoccupied spaces. So they are very useful in order to save the energy. Like on the left side of the corner, I have shown the practical occupancy sensor that you can see anywhere on the in the malls, offices, yeah, badi buildings mein aap dekhoge, these occupancy sensors, they are installed. So you can check these, and different types is infrared, ultrasonic and acoustic sensors. Infrared, jisse humari the heat generated due to the movement of the persons in the room. The heat generated that will detect whether the room is occupied or not. Then ultrasonic, the waves, आपस में जो बात करते हैं अगर कुछ भी वेव्स निकलती हैं सिमिलरली अकोस्टिक सो ऑल दीज टाइप ऑफ डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ सेंसर्स दे आर अवेलेबल इन मार्केट सो दीज आर द ऑक्यूपेंसी सेंसर्स सो दिस इज ऑक्यूपेंसी सेंसर टेक्नोलॉजीज नेक्स्ट देयर इज अ टाइम बेस्ड कंट्रोल टाइम बेस्ड कंट्रोल में सब माइक्रो प्रोसेसर डिवाइसेस जिसमें कुछ प्रोग्राम होता है जिसमें हम एक टाइम फिक्स कर देते हैं कि इतने टाइम के लिए आवर डिवाइस और अप्लायंस विल स्विच ऑन बट इसका ये ड्रॉबैक है अगर टाइम फिनिश हो गया इट विल स्विच ऑफ द लाइट्स वेदर द पर्सन इज देयर और नॉट दिस इज द मेन डिसएडवांटेज टाइम बेस्ड कंट्रोल सो टाइम्ड टर्न ऑफ स्विचेस दे आर अवेलेबल विद अ वाइड रेंज ऑफ टाइम स्पेंस different different times पे होते हैं it is a kind of automatic lighting control shorter time spans they waste less energy but increase the probability that the lights will turn off when someone is in the space this is the main drawback of the time based control and for most application the best choice is it is an electronic switch then the spring wound dial timer ठीक है what is the difference between these two I will show you. So on the upper two, they are the electronic timers, जिसमें हमारा time
Thank you.
So after discussing the occupancy sensor, the time-based controls of the lighting system, next another important controller is the daylight linked controller. Because when we are talking about the usage of energy, the lighting, so most the time we should use, keep, we should maximum utilize the solar energy, whether or where it is available, depending upon kya area hai. So maximum you should use the solar energy. Photoelectric cells, they can be used either simply to switch lighting on and off or for dimming. So depend karta hai ki area mein kaise, agar pura andhera it should be on, agar proper light it should be off, aur agar suppose thoda kam hogi it should be for the dimming. Yes, this ensures that the sum of the daylight and electric lighting, it always reaches the design level by sensing the total light in the control area. It should sense the total light and adjusting the output of the electric lighting accordingly. The energy saving potential of the dimming control is greater than simply a switch on off system. Yeah, switch on off, there is proper intensity bhi aakar, either it is off or on. But agar hum dimming control ke saath bhi use kare, it will impart a more greater potential. So this type of photo cells, like first case, if there is enough daylight, and secondly, it can also, you can collaborate it with the occupancy sensors. Daylight control plus occupancy sensor. Daylight enough hai, plus the room is occupied, then the lights will off. Secondly, daylight reduce ho rahi hai, but still the room is occupied, then the lighting will be dimmed. Third, night hai, but room is occupied, lighting on. Right? Next, fourth case, enough daylight, but the room is unoccupied. So that doesn't mean ki light, jab jaye kam bhi ho jaye, tab bhi on nahi hogi. In all the last three cases, the light will be off because there is an occupancy sensor that will sense whether the room is occupied or not. And secondly, there are photovoltaic cells that will determine, that will sense the intensity of the light available. So these types of the daylight controls, they are available. So next is your localized switching, that is also a part of the lighting control. Localized switching, like the normal switches जिस पे हमारा, हम अपने विजुअल इफेक्ट से देखते हैं, वी जस्ट सी व्हाट आर द आर विजुअल इफेक्ट्स. इफ वी फील कि लाइट सफिशिएंट है, वी स्विच ऑफ दिस. इफ वी फील कि नहीं सफिशिएंट नहीं है, वी स्विच ऑन द लाइट. दैट इज अ लोकलाइज्ड स्विच. जो लोकल स्विचेस होते हैं हमारे, द लोकल स्विचेस, दे गिव इंडिविजुअल ऑक्यूपेंट्स कंट्रोल ओवर देयर विजुअल एनवायरमेंट एंड ऑल्सो एनेबल एनर्जी सेविंग्स. वो खुद पे, हर किसी के अपने उस पर डिपेंड करते हैं. By using localized switching, it is possible to turn off the artificial lights in the specific area while still operating it in the other areas. वो different different switches के साथ connected, जिस area में हमें नहीं required, we can switch it off. ठीक है, it totally, it is manual, not automatic. So this was all about the energy efficient lighting controls, different controllers. Next is energy efficient lamps. I think the energy efficient lamps, ये तो हम सब ने सुने भी होंगे, सब use भी कर रहे हैं and implement भी कर चुके हैं. Already we have implemented these, but I will just go through these. What are these energy efficient lamps? CFL lighting, that is compact fluorescent lamps. Efficient, less expensive, it reduces air and water pollution, high quality light and versatile. And similarly, the LEDs, long lasting hai, durable hai, cost effective hai, more efficient hai. Also it reduces air and water pollution because there is no need to light your like any type of fire or anything else that will create the pollution. So, पहले हमारे incandescent चलते थे, CFL आ गए, then now we are using the LEDs. ठीक है, there is a comparison between the CFL. Just go through with this because I think all of you will know what is a CFL and LED. But this was, it is a type of the energy efficient technology. So I want to discuss. It saves up to 75%, 80%. Then CFL, it lasts for 9 years, LEDs last up to 20 years, contain a small amount of mercury, LEDs not contain mercury, then available in medium basis to fit standard light sockets, they are also available in medium to standard lights, they are less expensive, LEDs they are much slightly more expensive. So if we compare the output, LEDs of 4 watt is equal to CFL of 11 watt or incandescent lamp of 40 watt. So it depends upon you, given the...
LED is working on very low voltage as well.
Yes.
Very low
voltage. Very low.
Low voltage, 10
volts. Mm-hmm. Yes. So overall, so another comparison. So I think you all know incandescent lamp, CFL, LEDs. So wattage भी हमारी reduce होती है, तो obviously हमारी energy की usage कम होगी, life ज़्यादा है, cost पे थोड़ा सा effect पड़ता है, but that will be compensate. So next is your maximum demand controller. Now what is maximum demand controller? Maximum demand, I have already explained it earlier, ki when you are using energy, the number of units you consume, that will generate a load curve. If during the whole period of suppose 30 days, जिसमें आपका bill generate होता है, if your load curve is like this, stable, a constant wave, just small fluctuations, they will generate the bill according to that. But if your load touches, suppose say for a 30 minutes in full 1 month, if your load touches a peak value, that peak value will be included in your bill. So in order to overcome this, you have to check ki during the peak demand, what are the non-essential loads jisko aap switch off kar do, taki jo aapka jo load curve hai wo stable rahe, zyada peak demands ko touch na kare. Agar aap nahi usko khud nahi judge kar sakte, there are some controllers that can decide. They will give you a signal, alarm baj rahega. Okay? So consumers have to pay a maximum demand charge in addition to the usual charge for the number of units consumed. The maximum demand charge often represents a large proportion of the total bill and may be based on only one isolated 30 minute period of high power use. Just a 30 minute period ke liye, agar aapne apni, सपोज आपने अपने घर के सारे एसी, फ्रिज, ईच एंड एवरीथिंग आपने ऑन कर दिया, वो आपकी मैक्सिमम डिमांड को टच करेगा, देन योर बिल विल बी जनरेटेड अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट मैक्सिमम डिमांड. सो यू हैव टू बी वेरी केयरफुल एंड फॉर दैट द कंट्रोलर्स आर मेंट फॉर, दीज कंट्रोलर्स. एंड द कंसिडरेबल सेविंग कैन बी रियलाइज्ड बाय मॉनिटरिंग पावर यूज एंड टर्निंग ऑफ और रिड्यूसिंग द नॉन एसेंशियल लोड्स ड्यूरिंग सच पीरियड्स ऑफ हाई पावर यूज. A maximum demand controller, it is a device designed to meet the need of the industries aware of the value of the load management. Jinko pata hai ki humne apna load manage karna. Then an alarm is sounded when the demand approaches a preset jo present value jab hamari peak ko touch karegi the alarm will be sounded. If corrective action is, I think it's not present value, it's a preset value. कि उसमें हमने अपनी कुछ वैल्यू प्रीसेट की हुई है कि अगर उस प्रीसेट वैल्यू को हमारी डिमांड टच हो जाएगी दे विल गिव यू अलार्म साउंड एंड इफ करेक्टिव एक्शन इज नॉट टेकन द कंट्रोलर स्विचेस ऑफ द नॉन एसेंशियल लॉट्स इन द लॉजिकल सीक्वेंस. वो सारा कुछ हमारा एक प्रोग्राम पीएलसी के साथ रिलेटेड होगा. प्रोग्राम बना होगा पूरा एक लॉजिक सीक्वेंस बना होगा. जैसे ही अलार्म आएगा इट विल कट ऑफ द नॉन एसेंशियल लॉट्स. This sequence is predetermined by the user and it is programmed jointly by the user and the supplier of the device. The device, the supplier who will give you the controller, demand controller. ठीक है, just this type के होते हैं जो हमारे right hand side है. It is a type of maximum demand controller. Circuit diagram में आपके यही होता है इसके कि हमारे पास एक comparator होता है जिसने हमारी इनपुट सिग्नल को देना है जितनी हमारी यूसेज हुई है दोनों को हम कंपेयर करेगा. इफ इट टचेज दी देन इट विल गिव यू अ सिग्नल. फिर वो हमारा पूरा एक लॉजिक सीक्वेंस बना होगा जिसमें हमारा वन बाय वन वो रिले के साथ कनेक्टेड होंगे जिससे हमारा नॉन एसेंशियल लोड जो है वन बाय वन इट विल बी स्विच ऑफ. ठीक है, ये देखो ये ग्राफ में भी हमने दिया हुआ है. द रेड पोर्शन इज इफ यू आर यूजिंग इट विदाउट मैक्सिमम डिमांड कंट्रोल दैट विल टचेज यूर पीक डिमांड. Then your bill will be generated according to that. But if you are using it with the maximum demand controller, your bill will be generated according to your average load. So it is very important issue in the electrical technology. So last is your automatic power factor controller. Power factor, we know that either it is cos phi is equal to r by z, it is a ratio of the real to the apparent power. सो पावर फैक्टर में हमने मेनली पावर को कंट्रोल करना है. इसमें हमारे पास वोल्टेज कंट्रोल आ सकते हैं, केवीआर कंट्रोल आ सकता है. ठीक है, ऑटोमेटिक पावर फैक्टर कंट्रोलर भी आते हैं बिकॉज इन द पावर फैक्टर कैपेसिटर में आपको इट गिव्स द रिएक्टिव पावर, इंडक्टर इट टेक्स द रिएक्टिव पावर. सो यू हैव टू कंपेंसेट इट सो दैट आवर पावर फैक्टर शुड बी बिटवीन 0 to 1. सो व्हाट आर ऑटोमेटिक पावर फैक्टर कंट्रोलर? It can be controlled in two ways, either the voltage control or the KVAR control. Voltage alone, it can be used as a source of intelligence when the switched capacitors they are applied at a point where the circuit voltage decreases as the circuit load increases. Okay, we know that how we can control the power. Mostly, हम कैसे कहते हैं? Power factor को हम कैसे control करते हैं? By use of capacitors. ठीक है. जितना जितना हमें कैपेसिटर ऑटोमेटिक पावर फैक्टर कंट्रोलर ने इन सिंपल टर्म्स इट विल यूज द कैपेसिटर्स वन बाय वन. जितना जैसे जैसे हमारा पावर फैक्टर हमने कंट्रोल करो इट विल यूज दैट. जनरली वेयर दे आर अप्लाइड द वोल्टेज शुड डिक्रीज एज द सर्किट लोड इंक्रीजेज एंड द ड्रॉप इन वोल्टेज शुड बी अराउंड 4 to 5% विद इंक्रीजिंग लोड. Voltage is the most common type of intelligence used in the substation appliance applications when maintaining a particular voltage is of prime importance. This type of control is independent of the load cycle because hum pehle substations pe hi dekh rahe hain. Humne wahin par agar apni voltage ko control kar liya then accordingly we can control the power factor because power factor cos phi is also equal to power upon VI. That during the light loads time and low source voltage this may give the leading power factor at the substation. Another is KVAR kilowatt control jisko hum kehte hain. Kilowatt sensitive controls they are used at the locations where the voltage level is closely regulated but it is not controlled. Isse pehle humne voltage level jahan par jaise substations mein maine aapko bataya where we can control the voltage wahan par hum wo voltage controllers use kar sakte hain. इसमें जहां पर हमारे पास वोल्टेज रेगुलेटेड है बट इट इज नॉट कंट्रोल देन वेयर वी कैन यूज द केवीआर कंट्रोल. द कैपेसिटर्स इट कैन बी स्विच्ड टू रिस्पॉन्ड टू अ डिक्रीजिंग पावर फैक्टर एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ चेंज इन सिस्टम लोडिंग. नाउ दीज टाइप ऑफ पावर फैक्टर कंट्रोलर्स दे विल डिपेंड अपॉन द लोड. जो हमारे वोल्टेज वाले थे वो इट इज इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ द लोड. ठीक है, तो ये लोड पे डिपेंड करता है. जैसे जैसे हमारा लोड होगा उस अकॉर्डिंगली हम अपने कैपेसिटर्स को स्विच ऑन कर देते हैं सो दैट आवर पावर फैक्टर शुड बी मेंटेन. दिस टाइप ऑफ कंट्रोल कैन आल्सो बी यूज्ड टू अवॉइड द पेनल्टी ऑन द लो पावर फैक्टर बाय एडिंग कैपेसिटर्स इन स्टेप्स एज द सिस्टम पावर फैक्टर बिगिंस टू लैग बिहाइंड द डिजायर्ड वैल्यू. ठीक है, इट रिक्वायर्स टू इनपुट्स करंट एज वेल एज द वोल्टेज फ्रॉम द इनकमिंग फीडर विच आर फेड टू द पावर फैक्टर करेक्शन मैकेनिज्म आइदर द माइक्रोप्रोसेसर और थ्रू द रिले। ठीक है, अल्टीमेटली हमारा जो सारा है वो हमारा इलेक्ट्रॉनिक बेस्ड ही है, क्योंकि माइक्रोप्रोसेसर लेंगे, पीएलसी में यूज कर सकते हैं, रिले जो ऑटोमेटिक रिलेज यूज करते हैं, ठीक है, ताकि उस अकॉर्डिंगली हमारे कैपेसिटर उतने स्विच ऑन और स्विच ऑफ हो जाएंगे। ऑटोमेटिक पावर फैक्टर कंट्रोलर वही है, बिकॉज हमारा जो रिले है इट इज अ ब्रेन ऑफ द कंट्रोल सर्किट। अल्टीमेटली पूरे कंट्रोल सर्किट का ब्रेन हमारी रिले है, और उस रिले ने ही आगे ऑपरेट करनी है हमारे कैपेसिटर्स को। सो इट कंट्रोल्स द पावर फैक्टर ऑफ द इंस्टॉलेशन बाय गिविंग सिग्नल्स टू स्विच ऑन और ऑफ द पावर फैक्टर करेक्शन कैपेसिटर्स, जितने हमें चाहिए उस अकॉर्डिंगली। देन रिले इट इज अ ब्रेन ऑफ द कंट्रोल सर्किट and it needs contactors of appropriate rating for switching on off the capacitors. There is a built-in power factor transducer which measures the power factor of the installation and convert it to a DC voltage of appropriate polarity. So, us accordingly, usko hum manage karte hain. Then there's intelligent power factor controller, automatic power factor controller and intelligent power factor controller. They are the same, not very much different. Automatic means intelligently we are determining it. Okay? This controller determines the rating of the capacitance connected in each step during the first hour of its operation and then stores them in memory. ठीक है, ऑटोमेटिक में बस हमारे पास ये मेमोरी ही नहीं होती, इंटेलिजेंट में हमारे पास मेमोरी भी होती है। Based on this measurement, the intelligent power factor controller switches on the most appropriate steps, thus eliminating the hunting problems normally associated with the capacitor switching. Right. So these are the different energy efficient technologies that are there are many more technologies, like one which I have already skipped, give the variable speed drives. ठीक है, उसमें हमारे पास टॉर्क ड्राइव, पावर ड्राइव, कई तरह के स्पीड, इंडक्शन मोटर स्पीड की ड्राइव्स, इन सिंक्रोनस मोटर ड्राइव्स, सो देर आर सो मेनी ड्राइव्स, और वो ऑल दी ड्राइव्स दे आर बेस्ड ऑन दी पावर इलेक्ट्रॉनिक डिवाइसेस, जिससे कि हम अपनी मोटर की स्पीड, पावर फैक्टर, ये सारी चीजों को, टॉर्क को, पावर को, ईच एंड एवरीथिंग वी कैन कंट्रोल। सो इन दिस लेक्चर आई हैव डिस्कस सम ऑफ द एनर्जी एफिशिएंट टेक्नोलॉजीज, एनर्जी एफिशिएंसी, कंजर्वेशन, इंडिया में क्या कुछ चल रहा है, व्हाट इज कंजर्वेशन एक्ट, हमारा रेगुलेटरी फ्रेमवर्क क्या है, एंड डिफरेंट डिफरेंट सप्लाई साइड पे, डिमांड साइड पे, हम क्या कुछ कहाँ कहाँ पर हम अपनी एनर्जी को एफिशिएंटली यूज कर सकते हैं, विच टेक्नोलॉजी वी कैन अप्लाई। ठीक है, सो नाउ फाइनली व्हाट आर द प्रैक्टिकली हम कहाँ कहाँ पर, जहां पर हम अपने खुद, अपने कंज्यूमर लेवल पर हम कहाँ कहाँ पर इस चीजों को ऑप्ट कर सकते हैं, क्या कुछ देख सकते हैं, जस्ट इन सिंपल टर्म्स। सो आई विल गो थ्रू ऑल दीज पॉइंट्स दे आर बेस्ड ऑन द ऑल द टेक्नोलॉजीज वी हैव डिस्कस्ड सो फार। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल कंसिडर कि कस्टमर्स का आइडिया क्या है, किस टाइप की उनके पास यूसेज है और किस टाइप की उन्होंने एफिशिएंसी। ठीक है, और ये सारी जो चीजें होती हैं, दिस इज डन बाय द एनर्जी ऑडिटर्स। ठीक है, जो BEE वाले हैं, एक सर्टिफाइड कोर्स भी कराते हैं एनर्जी मैनेजर्स एंड ऑडिटर्स का। ठीक है, इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियर्स दे आर एलिजिबल, आई थिंक और भी ब्रांचेस के भी होंगे, आई एम नॉट वेरी मच श्योर, बट यू कैन लुक फॉर द BEE साइट इफ यू हैव द सर्टिफाइड कोर्स ऑफ दैट एनर्जी ऑडिटर्स एंड मैनेजर, देन यू कैन गो फॉर एनर्जी ऑडिटिंग फील्ड ऑल्सो। They will do the energy auditing, they will analyze your equipments, they will analyze all the motors, etc., all these things, then they will finally prepare a report, they will submit the report, and finally you can it is only the organization ki whether they are going to implement these measures or not, if they want to really want to save the energy. So consider the customer idea, any safety, vandalism and the theft issues. Turn off any extra equipment at all times. Perform any scheduled or deferred maintenance, repairs and tuning. Check the design and the performance of the equipment and its control. Check its design. Pura uska design check karo, uski performance kaise chal rahi hai, time to time. With a specific interval of time, you have to see all these things. upgrade or replace any worn, broken, obsolete, incorrectly sized, or otherwise inefficient equipment. Optimize the equipment staging, sequencing, schedules, pressures, temperature. जहाँ जहाँ पर भी वो applicable है. Not in all the cases. Recommission the facilities, जो जो हमारी facilities हमारे पास available है, उसको एक बार दोबारा से देखना. Then optimizing the lighting levels, fixtures and controls. ये तो हमने अपनी technology में भी discuss किया. What are the different lighting controls? कैसे कैसे हम कहाँ पर कहाँ कहाँ पर हमें उसकी यूसेज है और कैसे कैसे हम उसको इम्प्लीमेंट कर सकते हैं. अपग्रेड और रिप्लेस एनी इनएफिशिएंट इंटीरियर एंड एक्सटीरियर लाइट्स सच एज इनकैंडेसेंट, हैलोजन, मैरिक्रो, जहाँ जहाँ पर आपकी रिक्वायरमेंट है. देर आर सम स्टैंडर्ड्स, T12 हो गया जैसे, या देर आर सम स्टैंडर्ड्स दैट इज फिक्स्ड बाय द BEE कि किस लाइट्स के कितनी एफिशिएंसी है, कितनी उसकी वॉटेज है. Install Energy Star Compact CFLs and T5, T8 fluorescent lights with the electronic blast. I think electronic blast तो पता है ना क्या होते हैं? Electronic blast. In fluorescent lights, there are two electrodes. These electrodes, they are not electrically connected. When we impress voltage on it, yeah, there is a charge between these two, right? But since they are not electrical connected, there should be some connection with the supply. There should be some ancillary services that needs to be, so that jo hamari CFL hai, it should remain illuminated. Usko control bhi karna hai, plus it should remain illuminated. It should operate and illuminate for the longer period. So for that, jo electronic blast hum lagate hai usme. ठीक है, उसका भी एक पूरा प्रॉपर डायग्राम वगैरह होता है. हाँ, बिकॉज जस्ट टू मेक अ कनेक्शन बिटवीन दीज टू. देन इंस्टॉल एफिशिएंट हाई इंटेंसिटी डिस्चार्ज लाइट्स सच एज हाई प्रेशर सोडियम लाइट्स, पल स्टार्ट, डिपेंडिंग अपॉन दी कितनी को इंटेंसिटी की हमें लाइट चाहिए. इंस्टॉल फोटो सेल्स, टाइमर्स, डिमर्स, ऑक्यूपेंसी सेंसर्स, ये हम सब अभी कर चुके हैं. स्वीप ऑफ द मेन लाइट्स एट नाइट एंड वेन एवर द बिल्डिंग इज नॉट ऑक्यूपाइड. Consider daylighting, light surfaces, shades and overhangs. जहाँ जहाँ पर हम maximum time daylight use कर सकते हैं. Optimize the refrigerations and building HVAC shell, fenestration and cold and hot water equipment, including compressors, chillers, units, air conditioners. ये सारा these all things they are applicable to the factories and industries. वहां पर ये सब कुछ यूज होता है. हॉट एंड कोल्ड वाटर कूलर्स भी यूज होते हैं, इकोनोमाइजर्स भी यूज होते हैं, वेपोरेटर्स भी यूज होते हैं, कंडेंसर्स भी यूज होते हैं. सो दे हैव टू लुक फॉर ऑल दीज थिंग्स. इवेपोरेटिव कंडेंसर्स, बॉयलर्स, वाटर हीटर्स, पंप्स, फैंस, मोटर्स, टैंक्स, पाइपिंग, डक्टिंग, इंसुलेशन, इंस्ट्रूमेंटेशन, उसका कंट्रोल्स. Insulate or re-insulate the walls, ceiling, cold or hot tanks, piping, ducting, जहाँ जहाँ पर applicable है. Install window film. ठीक है, अगर suppose हमारा कोई cold वाला है area जिसको हमने ठंडा ही रखना है, so install the window films. ठीक है, ताकि जो उसकी heat या light वो बाहर ना generate हो. Replace any inefficient single pane window with efficient double pane wherever required. Install premium efficiency motors. Then install super efficient rare earth permanent magnet motors. Rare earth वो magnetic materials होते हैं जिससे हमारे पास motor की efficiency और increase होती है. So super efficient rare earth materials use करो for the motors. Cool the compatible areas or equipment with outside air or cooling tower water when feasible. Increase the capacity of the economizers, cooling towers and evaporative condensers. Upgrade the cooling tower. Install side stream filters on the cooling towers and evaporative condensers. Float the head pressure in the refrigeration system. Upgrade the chemical treatment system. Optimize the compressed and blown air pumping process, heating, cooling. Okay, these are all different measures depending upon kis type ki aapki requirement hai on the factory. Identify and repair any compressed air leaks. Minimize the system operating because हर चीज जो है आपकी एनर्जी के साथ रिलेटेड है, आपके रिसोर्सेज के साथ रिलेटेड है. कहीं से कोई लीकेज भी हो रही है तो वो भी आपके रिसोर्सेज के साथ रिलेटेड है. वी हैव टू preserve our resources, we have to use these resources more efficiently. So, किसी तरह की कोई leakage है, install a new main or secondary air compressor with an adjustable speed drives. Install adjustable speed drives on the compatible compressors, pumps, and other motorized equipments. Test the boilers with a stacked glass analyzer from the Pacific Energy Center. Install boiler and water heater controllers to minimize equipment, like hot water temperature, usko optimize karna. Recover more steam condensate. Install a waste heat recovery system. Upgrade the boiler with the most efficient burners. Use kar sakte hain. Install super efficient condensing boilers. Optimizing the water purification. Usko recycle kaise kar sakte hain. Kitna kaise hum uski maximum usage kar sakte hain. Optimize the waste minimization recycling. Replace any inefficient. अगर कुछ भी हमारे पास aerators है वो inefficient है उसको replace कर दो. Optimize the conveyors, loaders, unloaders, packagers, battery chargers, सब चीजों का optimize करना. ठीक है, हम भी अगर अब किसी भी चीज में research करते हैं हमारा main idea क्या होता है, we have to optimize. कुछ भी चाहे हम एक motor की designing भी कर रहे हैं हमें यही लिखते हैं ना कि हम we have to optimize the design. और जब optimum design आता है तो उसमें कई factors आ जाते हैं. There are so many factors. ये वाला आप देखो 40 point देख सकते हो. Optimize the office, conference room, break room, business center, जो आपके अपने level पे हैं, जो आप अपने घरों में भी कर सकते हो, ताकि हमारे अपना उसी की design को ही हम कितना कर सकते हैं. Enable the Energy Star sleep mode, computers पे, printers पे जो आते हैं आपके sleep modes, ठीक है. Install Energy Star refrigerators. जितने हम घरों में भी मैंने आपको बताया जैसे BEE के स्टार रेटिंग्स के अकॉर्डिंगली लो, जितना मोर एफिशिएंट लोगे उतनी आपकी एनर्जी सेविंग होगी. जितने भी हाई एफिशिएंसी अप्लायंसेस हैं आपके, एसी हो गया, डिशवॉशर्स हो गए, देन हाई एफिशिएंसी अदर एसी और रेफ्रिजरेटर्स हो गए, माइक्रोवेव्स हो गए, ठीक है, स्टार रेटिंग्स भी. इंस्टॉल एनर्जी स्टार रूफ प्रोडक्ट्स, ठीक है, बिकॉज आई हैव नॉट टच्ड दिस बिल्डिंग वाला जो पार्ट है ना कि एनर्जी एफिशिएंट बिल्डिंग कोड्स, बिकॉज इट इज अ सेपरेट पार्ट नॉट रिलेटेड विद द इलेक्ट्रिकल, सो आई हैव नॉट कवर्ड दैट पार्ट अंडर दिस बिकॉज इट इज ऑल रिलेटेड विद द इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर, द डिफरेंट बिल्डिंग कोड्स, उनके स्टैंडर्ड्स क्या हैं, लेबल्स, ठीक है. यहाँ पर ये चीज है कि इंस्टॉल एनर्जी स्टार रूफ प्रोडक्ट्स. रूफ प्रोडक्ट्स मीन्स जितने भी हमारी मोस्टली अगर इस केस में हम देखें तो लाइटनिंग, फैंस, एसी, जो जो हम रूफ पे इंस्टॉल कर रहे हैं, कैसे उनकी मैक्सिमम यूसेज रखनी है हमने, ठीक है. हमने कहीं ना कहीं ऐसी अपनी विंडोज लगानी है जहां से हमारे पास मैक्सिमम डे लाइट. सपोज दिस इज योर वर्क एरिया, सो ट्राई कि हमारा जहां पर डे लाइट आ सकती है बिल्कुल एग्जैक्टली उसके ऊपर, ताकि उसकी मैक्सिमम यूसेज हो. सबसे ज्यादा एनर्जी यू कैन सेव फॉर द लाइटनिंग at your local level. You can replace the lights, sensors laga do, time based laga do, whatever is matlab depending upon kaisi aapki requirement hai. So this is all from my side, what are the different energy efficient technologies, what measures you can take, because energy management and auditing, when you are going for manage the energy, when you are going for the auditing, all these areas are related with the how efficiently you are using your energy. So energy ko manage karna means aapne apne resources manage karne. Resources manage karna means aap apni energy ko utna hi efficiently use kar rahe ho. Efficiently use kar rahe ho means aap kaun kaun si latest technology laga rahe ho. Each and everything matters. Aur technology aapko maine all sab bata di hai. मोटर्स पे लगा सकते हो, ट्रांसफार्मर पे, लाइट्स पे लगा सकते हो आप, बिल्डिंग्स का जैसे मैंने आपको बताया कि आई हैव नॉट टच्ड बिल्डिंग्स पे भी आप अपनी, जैसे बताया था ना कि BEE वाले पावर के लिए देते हैं तो दे आल्सो गिव द स्टार रेटिंग्स फॉर द बिल्डिंग कोड्स. जैसे वो प्रॉपर एक पैनल बना होता है, सेम पैनल इज फॉर द बिल्डिंग्स, पूरा उसकी पूरी बिल्डिंग की ऑडिटिंग होती है. But nowadays it is compulsory for all the industries and factories to go for energy auditing because they have to save, they have to analyze कि कितनी energy उनकी use है, कितनी कर रहे हैं, proper calculations होती है, how much energy they are using, proper प्रॉपर पूरी वोल्टेज करंट कितनी वो विड्रॉ कर रहे हैं, पावर कैलकुलेट होती है, पावर फैक्टर कैलकुलेट होता है, ईच एंड एवरीथिंग, कितने यूनिट्स कंज्यूम हो रहे हैं, कैसे यूसेज है, डे में ज्यादा यूज है कि नाइट में, ठीक है। जैसे मैंने आपको एक और चीज बताई थी कि मैक्सिमम डिमांड कंट्रोलर है, ताकि हमारी जो मैक्सिमम डिमांड है वो पीक को ना टच हो। इसीलिए कई जो लार्ज फैक्ट्रीज वाले हैं दे गो फॉर अ डे एंड नाइट शिफ्ट, सो दैट कि पूरे एक ही दिन में डे टाइम में ही उनका लोड इतना मत बढ़ जाए कि वो मैक्सिमम डिमांड को टच हो जाए। सो दैट इज व्हाई दे गो फॉर डे एंड नाइट शिफ्ट। उससे भी उनकी एनर्जी मैनेज होती है, उनका टैरिफ, उनका जो टैरिफ का स्ट्रक्चर है, बिल जिसे हम कहते हैं इलेक्ट्रिसिटी बिल, वो मैनेज हो जाता है, क्योंकि जो आपका बिल है इट इज टोटली डिपेंडेंट अपॉन द एवरेज लोड प्लस द मैक्सिमम डिमांड। हर कस्टमर का, हर कंज्यूमर का लोड स्पेसिफाइड होता है, इट इज स्पेसिफाइड बाय द डिफरेंट और स्टेट इलेक्ट्रिसिटी डिपार्टमेंट्स। हर घर का एक लोड स्पेसिफाइड है। इफ यू आर गोइंग टू परचेज अ अप्लायंस और वो आपके लोड से बाहर है, then you have to look for it. So these are the different measures that you can go for. So thank you all for your attention.